Joseph Edward Rall was born on February 3, 1920, in Naperville, Illinois, to Dr. Edward E. Rall, president of North Central College, and Nell Platt Rall. From an early age, he knew he wanted to get to the top. He also liked to get things moving, whether his grandfather Platt, on three wheels, or on four. This interest stayed with Ed all his life at his beloved farm or with his grandchildren. Ed's brother David was born in 1926. Through the Illinois winters and short pants, they shared a strong bond. Dave followed his brother's footsteps to North Central College, to Northwestern Medical School, and onto a brilliant scientific career. The Rall men worked together and played together. Ed met the love of his life, Caroline Dahm, very early. Here she is at Ed's fourth birthday. Caroline and Ed were married in 1944. Their fathers, Professor Edward Dahm and Dr. Edward Rall, were colleagues at North Central College and close friends. Few people realize that Caroline, who had a degree in science and worked in the lab at Mayo Clinic, was Ed's unacknowledged scientific editor. This is the only photo ever taken of Ed dancing. They were on board the SS United States in 1961, en route to a year-long sabbatical in Paris. Caroline was by his side when he received an honorary degree from their alma mater, North Central College. Ed lost his beloved Caroline in 1976. Ed was a sportsman from an early age. His love of horses continued through the years, and he passed it on to his granddaughters. He also enjoyed skiing here at Garmisch, Germany in 1947. Caroline, a college tennis champion, did her best to teach him the game. Ed was never at a loss for an outlet for his prodigious energy. Here he's skipping rocks. The Rawls often skated on the Siena Canal. Here is Ed at 70 skating on his daughter's farm pond with his grandchildren. Ed had an artistic side. As a youngster, he was intrigued by photography. He filmed his travels to Russia and to the Marshall Islands in the late 1950s. Ed inherited his mother's gift of music and played the piano from an early age. Classical music was his forte, shared by his wife Caroline and passed on to their daughter and granddaughters. Sailing was another of Ed's passions. While in New York, he even bought a small sailboat. Later, he sailed with Chris Anthonsen up and down the East Coast, as well as in Finland with Panu Vilki. In his last years, he sailed in the Caribbean with Zanuck and Marta, postdocs doing genetic research on jellyfish. If a sailboat was not available, he could still be found out on the water. In 1947, Ed joined the Army. After a rigorous boot camp, he was stationed in Germany. Later, Caroline joined him, and they traveled throughout Europe. Back in the U.S., he finished his Ph.D. at the Mayo Clinic and then went to the Big Apple to work at Sloan Kettering. He had enjoyed lab work for many years, but even more so now. In 1950, Ed and Caroline had a daughter, Priscilla. Priscilla, or Pia as she was called, was often at his side, and this was true for many years. In 1953, Ed and Caroline had a son, Edward Christian, called Busty. Here is Ed with his family in 1963. In 1979, Ed welcomed his first grandchild, Caroline Elizabeth. Another grandchild, Amanda, was born in 1980. No longer Ed, he now answered to Pop-Up. Pop-Up shared his love of the farm with Caroline and Amanda. A third granddaughter, Joanna, was born in 1993. Ed watched his grandchildren grow. Here, the proud grandfather is showing off Amanda's prize-winning science fair project. Ed traveled to Mount Holyoke to see Caroline graduate in 2001. In 2003, he proudly watched as Amanda graduated from UMBC with Phi Beta Kappa honors. Ed's scientific credentials are well known. His research in endocrinology was groundbreaking. In 1955, he left New York for NIH. He worked long hours in the lab, and that love of basic science never left him. He fostered the work of many who later earned great honors. Even after retiring, he continued to work with postdocs, and his interest turned to genetics and genetic sequencing. His former postdocs, Zanuck and Marta from the Czech Republic, last visited him 2 months before he died, wanting his feedback and editorial skills before publishing their latest paper. Ed still reveled in good scientific discussions with colleagues. Ed's scientific pursuits took him to the Marshall Islands in 1957 and 1959 to research the effects of radiation. He returned 4 times in the 1970s. He also was part of the first scientific exchange with the Soviet Union. Ed made lifelong friends with his scientific colleagues all over the world. One of his most enduring relationships was with Jack Robbins, which began in New York in 1949. Other great friends were Nino Salvatore from Naples, Jamshed Tata from England, Jesse Roth, Jan and Edie Wolf, Henry Metzger, Hans Kahneman, Phil Gordon, Cy Wallman, Mario Andreoli, and many, many more. Even as his health failed, he did not want to miss the annual FAES Christmas party, even though he passed away 2 months later. Dr. Eugene Brody, his old friend of 60 plus years, described Ed Rall as indomitable. Yes, he could be fierce and frightening, but there was another side to Ed Rall. He could be a wild man, always ready for a challenge, something new or different, never afraid to be silly. But when he was mellow, he was very, very mellow. Ed Rall loved the arts, the sciences, and knowledge in general. He lived his life to the fullest until the end, facing every challenge with courage and grace. Ed Rall died February 28, 2008, with his family by his side.